Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal and today I'm back here in order to discuss a lot of MCQs with you for ESI section, which are going to be important for the upcoming NABARD, SEBI as well as RBI examination. For those who are watching this video for the first time, these MCQs are a method of revision for the upcoming examinations. And if you have not seen the previous videos, you should go and watch all the day-wise videos that I've been creating by discussing a lot of MCQs related to the upcoming exams. Today I'm going to take MCQs for the month of February 2019, that is MCQs which have been picked up from the current affairs which came out in the month of February. So let's start with the discussion. The first question for today is, a new concept of gross domestic knowledge product has been created. Identify the keywords. Gross domestic knowledge product, that is the first keyword. Which of the following is not the fundamental concept behind GDKP. Let's remove not, because I'm going to be answering which of the following is the fundamental concept behind GDKP. So let's look at the options and then try and answer the question. The first option is GDKP, gross domestic knowledge product. You should remember this. I'm expecting some kind of question from GDKP this month. Is a measure of the production of individual wealth based on knowledge. This is a keyword here. GDKP is a measure of production of nation's wealth based on knowledge. GDKP is a measure of production of individual's knowledge based on individual wealth. And the fourth one is GDKP is a measure of production of individual's knowledge based on nation's wealth. All these are the options. If you know what GDKP is, please put your answers in the comment section below before I answer them for you. Before discussing the answer, let's talk a little bit about GDKP. GDKP as a concept has been created or developed by Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation plus Indian Statistical Institute. They recently came out with this concept of GDKP. The second important element of GDKP, the first element is going to be one of these four. The second important element is that it helps the private sector identify what is the optimal capital investment, please understand these terms very carefully. Optimal capital investment in knowledge, that means in enhancing knowledge of its human resource, which can replace or which can give more output than capital investment elsewhere. Okay, that is what it helps the private sector identify. The first important element is one of these. Let me also tell you the four pillars of GDKP, which are a very, very important, based on which questions can be asked in the examination. The first one is knowledge items, KI. The second one is knowledge producer matrix, KPM. The third one is knowledge user matrix, KUM. And the fourth one is cost of individual learning. What is the cost attached to every individual learning? These are the four important pillars of GDKP. Now, which one is the measure of GDKP? The answer is A. GDKP is a measure of production of individual wealth based on knowledge. How much wealth can every individual generate based on his or her knowledge? That is what GDKP fundamentally is. So these are all the questions that can be asked from GDKP in the examination. Let's jump to the second question. The question says, approval has been granted for creation of AMIF. Provide me with the full form of AMIF if you already know it. Instead of giving you the full form, the examination normally has been following the trend of giving the acronyms, which are often confusing for students. With a corpus of 2000 crore, this needs to be remembered. A question can also be framed around this figure. AMIF is to be created with which organization? The options are RBI, SEBI, IRDAI, NABARD and SIDBI. If you know the answer, provide it in the comment section below. Till that time, let me discuss certain important things regarding AMIF with you. The full form of AMIF is Agri Market Infrastructure Fund. Agri Market Infra Fund. The Agri Market Infra Fund has been created, as I said, with a corpus of 2000 crore rupees. And the purpose is to provide funds to APMCs, agriculture producing marketing companies, as well as Grameen marketing markets. So all these Grameen infrastructure markets or Grameen markets plus APMCs are to be provided these funds in order to develop them, in order to provide them with the sufficient infrastructure, like cold storages, like an online system of marketing produce, online system of taking the produce from the farmers at the right price. All these things need to be developed. And the state governments are going to borrow money from this AMIF, whose corpus is 2000 crore, and provide these funds to APMCs as well as Grameen markets. Okay. Now, with which organization AMIF should have combined, should have come together, because it is connected with agriculture, high chances that it can be asked in NABARD examination. And obviously, the answer to this question is D, NABARD itself, because NABARD looks after agriculture regulation as well as its development. Let's come to the third question. The question says, what concern does declining LFPR, LFPR stands for labor force participation rate, raise in Indian employment scenario? The question is, what concern does declining LFPR raise in Indian employment scenario? Please tell me what LFPR, what is the formula of LFPR? If you know that in the comment section below, I would like to hear that. And what is the age range to be counted in LFPR? That will be our next question. So if you know the answer, provide it now itself, that will give you a boost in case your answer is correct when I discuss the next question. Well, LFPR, labor force participation rate, is the ratio or proportion of the people or the labor force in a certain age group upon the total population in the country. What is labor force? Labor force is the number of people who are willing and who are able to work, who are willing and who are able to work in the country. Well, declining LFPR means that either people are not willing anymore to work, or number of people who are willing to work is declining, or number of people who are able to work is declining. This is certainly not one of the cases, because we have a huge youth population. Unless all of them become unable, or majority of them become unable or incapable of working, this cannot be the scenario. So it means that people are not willing anymore to apply for work. They're looking for other opportunities other than employment. Let's have a look at the options. The first option says, it raises the question as to why are young people unable to find gainful employment. If a person is unable to find gainful employment, will he or she still be a part of LFPR or not? He will be a part of LFPR, and therefore this is not the correct answer. It raises the question as to why are young people unable to migrate from rural to urban areas. Migration has nothing to do with LFPR. Why are young people stuck in structural unemployment, and why are people stuck in frictional unemployment? Both of them are also incorrect. If they're unemployment, they're still a part of LFPR. It raises the question as to why are young people not looking for employment anymore. That means they are not willing to work anymore. They are not looking for employment anymore. Therefore, the answer is E for this question. The next question is connected with the previous question, as I said. The question is, LFPR is defined as the section of working population in the age group of dash in the economy currently employed or seeking employment. I believe you have already answered the question either in your own heads or in the comment section below. The answer to this question is B, 16 to 64 years of age. Very high chances that this question be asked in phase 1 of the upcoming NABARD examination. The reason being that LFPR was recently declared by NSSO to be well below previous years LFPRs, and the reasons have been provided by NSSO, but the government has not yet finalized the report. Okay. Let's come to the next question. Who among the following is the head of the committee made to review economic capital framework of RBI? What is the economic capital framework of RBI? You must have heard about the tussle between RBI and government, wherein the government demanded interim dividend from RBI. Interim dividend from RBI. And the RBI said that it cannot provide interim dividend at this point of time. And there were also reports which were saying that interim dividend means that government, RBI will have to print money, and therefore it might result into inflation in the economy. Well, that, how does it work? Let me explain to you. There are two kinds of dividends. There is one final dividend, and then there is the interim dividend. Final dividend is provided, or final dividend is declared after the company, or RBI in this instance, has already finalized its balance sheets for the entire year, and they have seen now or they have actually earned certain revenue surplus. So revenue surplus exists in case of final dividend, whereas in case of interim dividend, the surplus does not exist. Why? The surplus does not exist because in the middle of the year, the balance sheets have not yet been created. The surplus has not been yet been finalized for the year. There might be losses in the future in the same year. Therefore, the final dividend or the final revenue surplus has not yet been calculated. And therefore, if interim dividend is declared, it is declared based on forecasts only. It is based on forecast of revenue surplus. Therefore, in this case, RBI might have to resort to printing of money in order to provide this surplus to the government or distribute this surplus to the government in the form of dividend. And this will certainly result into inflation. Who among the following is the head of the committee? The answer is C for this question. I hope you have certain understanding about interim and final dividend now. More details about the impacts of interim dividend and final dividend and about the assumptions or conclusions that can be made out of these interims and final dividends have been provided in the PDFs on February current affairs for phase 2 ESI. The last question for today is, the demand by the central government regarding distribution of surplus by RBI has a deep meaning and reason behind it. Which of the following is one of those reasons? A question connected with interim and final dividend. It indicates that the government finances are under pressure. It indicates that the government finances are doing very well. It indicates that RBI's finances are under pressure. It indicates that RBI is on its way to follow global practices. You might be actually enticed to answer this one because a lot of newspapers are saying that global practices, under global practices, interim as well as final dividends are provided by the central bank to the government. But this is not the reason behind distribution of surplus by RBI, because the government is the one who made the demand of declaring independent interim dividend. It was not the RBI which came up with the idea of declaring and distributing interim dividend, saying that we want to follow global practices. It was the government which demanded it. Therefore, the reason also lies with the government, and that reason is certainly that the government is trying to reduce its fiscal deficits. The government is trying to reduce its fiscal deficits, and in order to do that, it saw that RBI can provide us a lot of money in the form of dividend. Why not take that? And through interim dividend, they gathered 28,000 crore, and through final dividend in the previous year, they gathered 40,000 crore, which makes a total of 68,000 crore in the previous financial year. Okay, so these were the questions, MCQs concerning the phase 2 or ESI section. A lot of these questions are important, and a lot of topics are important for the phase 1 of RBI as well as NABARD, and a lot of these topics are also important for the upcoming exam phase 2 and not phase 1. Okay, I hope you found this lecture very important, interesting as well as informative. For more such videos, subscribe to the channel and do not forget to press the bell icon, because every morning we come out with morning tales which help you start your day with the right set of questions, with the right set of quizzes, and with the right set of knowledge. All the very best. Take care.